Now let's look at several attacks on the web. The first is the cross-site scripting attack. Many websites allow users to input data and then simply display or echo data back. The website includes the user input data in the HTML page to the user's browser. Such websites include social networking sites, blogs, etc. But what if the users are attackers and the user input is malicious? Let's use an example to illustrate. Suppose a website echoes the user-supplied data, such as name, back to the user. Suppose user Joe visits a website and he supplies his name, Joe, to the website. Then the website will send back a page saying, "Hello, Joe." Now suppose instead of sending the user's name, Joe, to the website, the browser sends a script as his name. What's going to happen? The website will take this script as the user's name and echo it back to the web browser. That is, the script will be included in the HTML page sent to the browser. Therefore, when the browser displays this web page, the script will run. The web page will display "Hello World." Now, this is a benign case. Now, what if the script is malicious? When the browser gets the HTML page from the web server, it will just execute the script. So if the script is malicious, then the malicious script will be executed by the browser. But why would the browser send a malicious script to the website without the user knowing about it? How can this happen?